welcome to Breakout 12 here at the CCW Arena. We have a very exciting lineup for you tonight, and we'll hope that all of you will enjoy it. Who's ready to see the CCW Southeastern Champion, Jackal?
Ciatso, all the stars of Coastal Championships. Look out from behind. Noah King going right to work with Eddie Valentine, not waiting for the bell. Albeit a dirty move, it could have been a smart move on Noah King's part. Valentine slumped in the corner there, trying to work his way, finally got his jacket off. King now going to work the forearms to the side of the head in the corner. Big shoulder tackle by Eddie Valentine. Down goes Noah King. Boxer right, delivers a clothesline. King down. Big scoop slam. Noah King down in the center of the ring. Eddie Valentine. He was looking to drop that elbow. Noah King, though, wisely getting to the outside. Referee backing up Valentine. King now. Oh. King, good heads-up wrestling. Again, albeit a dirty move, certainly effective. And now a flatliner. He could have him here. It could be over that quick. One, two. Oh, Valentine able to raise the shoulder. Noah King now, choking Eddie Valentine in that center rope, all his weight across the back and neck. referee Christopher Costa admonishing him. Double axe handle the back of Eddie Valentine. Valentine in big trouble here in the corner. Noah King has been in control from the onset, except for a short spurt by Valentine. And King really on the attack. Ooh, a devastating knife edge chop in the corner. Referee trying to get him out of there, but to no avail. And again, King firing away with the chops to the chest. Oh, but Eddie Valentine delivers one of his own. Right hand, right forearm to the side of the head, and Valentine stumbles down to a hip. Noah King really staying on top of Eddie Valentine. The crowd now trying to bring Valentine back to his feet. Sunset flip could have him here. Referee position, two. Very close. High running knee. Goes for the cover. One, two. Oh, Valentine just inches away from losing this match. Valentine better turn it around quickly if he has any hopes of beating Noah King. King is really all over the veteran. King now trying to see, hard to see from my vantage point. He has a top wrist lock, possibly on Eddie Valentine, trying to wear him down. Valentine needs to get back up to a vertical base. There he is, he does, delivering an elbow to the midsection, trying to break his way free. And a right hand. Valentine with some momentum now. Oh! King caught him with a knee right in the breadbasket. Valentine in big trouble. King now. Dropping that knee, a little bit of timing off, but it's certainly effective. One, two. He got the two count. King now. With a head of steam coming up. Oh, man. He caught him with a knee square in the face. That's going to do it, two. Somehow, Eddie Valentine still has life left in him. Boy, Noah King has been in control almost the entire match. Valentine really needs to fire back if he has any chance of beating the prolific poet, Noah King. King now with the abdominal stretch right in the center of the ring. Could see a submission here. Valentine hanging on. Peels off that leg. Able to break free and escape with a hip toss. Not creating some separation between him and his opponent. King now trying to make his way back to his feet. Eddie Valentine in the corner. King now with a forearm. Valentine returns the favor. They're exchanging blows now. Valentine with a block. Valentine now firing away. And a big headbutt puts King down. One, two. Only a two count. Valentine needs to stay on Noah King. Valentine showing the effects of the punishment he's taken for most of the match. He's got King up on his shoulders, though. King able to break his way free, delivering a forearm to the side of the head. King now with a hammerlock, looking for the ripcord. Misses that clothesline. Throws him up. One, two, three. He got him! Eddie Valentine. Boy, he really snuck one in there. Valentine very fortunate to walk away with the victory here. Noah King really dominating this match. But Eddie Valentine shows that a veteran knows what to do. And that's all it took to get the three count. And we'll be back with more on CCW on Live Wrestling.
First, from Ponce, Puerto Rico, standing at 6'5" in
Wrestling fans, we're back on CCW Live Wrestling, making his way to the ring now, the former World Wrestling Council Heavyweight Champion, the Puerto Rican powerhouse, Abbad, now making his home here in South Florida, and has become a mainstay in Coastal Championship Wrestling. But I tell you what, as he usually towers over his opponent, it's not the case tonight. Abbad peering out over the crowd here in the CCW Arena. The second room. His opponent will be making his way to the ring shortly.
And his opponent from Port St. Lucie, Florida, by way of Essex, England, weighing in at 303 pounds and standing at 6'6" tall, the
Boss, the big man from Port St. Lucie, and this will be the first time, I believe, that Abbad has faced competition a little bit bigger than him. Abbad standing 6'5", the boss, 6 feet, 6 inches tall, and I believe he has a little bit of a weight advantage over Abbad as well, and here he comes, steering his way to the ring. The Boss, Big Fish, one of the most popular wrestlers here in Coastal Championship Wrestling. This is the first singles match between Abbad and the Boss. Although they have squared off against one another in Battle Royals. Abbad taking the powder there. Doesn't seem impressed with the bus. Taking his time getting back in the ring. Big English now. And Abbad getting ready to square off the battle of the big men here in CCW. Power and elbow dive in the center of the ring. A little bit of a feeling out process at first, I'm sure. Again, Abbad not used to wrestling somebody his own size. That's just the same goes for the bus. The crowd certainly behind the bus, not so much Abbad. Power and elbow dive again. Either man able to gain an advantage. Crowd really getting behind the bus here at the CCW Arena. Abbad now. Powering the bus back, a bus turning around on him. Now they're rolling around on the ropes there. Each man jockeying for position. Senior official Bruce Owens now calling for the break. Abbad though, powering the bus back into a neutral corner. There's the count by referee Bruce Owens. Oh, not a clean break. Just a pie face. Not doing any damage, but certainly raising the ire of the bus. The bus now in great hands. Reversal now by Abbad. Over that hip lock. Bus puts on the brakes. Nice reversal on the hip lock takeover. And a nice arm drag by the big man. And again, Abbad usually having that incredible size advantage. Not used to be able to get arm drag, but the bus certainly not in any way stopped for the size of Abbad. Abbad on the outside now, taking his time, getting back in the ring, collecting his thoughts there. Referee all the way up to a 7 count, though. He better be careful. I know in Puerto Rico, it's a 20 count to get back in the ring. Not sure how familiar Abbad is with the rules here in Coastal Championship Wrestling. Only get a 10 count on the outside. But to no avail, he's back in now, so it really doesn't matter. They try to get to the center of the ring. Abbad goes for the eyes. And again, referee warning him. Abbad. Incredible agility. The big man leaping up the top rope, using that momentum to arm drag the bus. And a flatliner. He could have him here. He's taking his time, though, not going for the cover. That could be a mistake. One. Referee Bruce Owen with a two count. A bye choke. The bus on the middle rope there. Bruce Owen's breaking that one up. Got the bus in the corner now. And a big knife edge chop. Boss trying to create some separation here. Abbad right back after him. And again, a big chop right to the chest. Wow. Big heavy-handed chop. Boss firing back with a boot to the midsection. And a forearm to the jaw. Now Boss has Abbad in the corner. And a chop to the chest of his own. Again, the bus firing a chop into the chest. Abbad struggling to get away. And again, Abbad goes to the eyes. Delivering an elbow to the top of the head. And again, Abbad now in control. Sending the bus in for the ride. Oh, what a big clothesline. Bus goes down hard. Covers him. One, two. Abbad now with a rear chin lock on the bus. All his weight across the back, neck, and shoulders. Now driving him down to the mat with even more leverage. The crowd trying to get in. The bus back to his feet. Bus now in a very precarious position. He needs to get back to his feet, alleviate some of that pressure. The bus pumping that arm, trying to come back to life. The crowd really behind the bus now. Back to a vertical base. Driving the arm into the midsection. He breaks free and a forearm to the side of the head. He's got Abbad reeling against the ropes. Send him to the ride. Abbad coming on with a flying shoulder tackle. The bus flat on his back. Abbad back in control. And he's mocking the bus. Abbad going to the outside. What does he have in mind here? The bus wisely rolling in the opposite direction. Abbad up to the top rope now. The bus back to his feet. Clippers an uppercut forearm. Abbad in trouble. The bus launches and lands it flat in the center of the ring. Big clothesline by the bus. Down goes Abbad. And a back elbow puts it flat on his back one more time. Big scoop. And a slam. The bus almost lost his balance. But it looks like he's going for the bus stop. He's got him in position. This is going to do it. He's pulling into the station. Oh, but Abbad out of the way. The bus saw it. Abbad rolls to the outside, breaks the momentum. The bus having none of that, though. He's coming right out after him. Abbad with a right hand on the outside here. The bus now. They're all close to our announce table here. Look out. Firing back is the bus. Oh, what a big chop. The bus firing back. They better pay attention to the referee's count. Referee up to a six count. Big forearm to the side of the head. Referee calls for the bell. Both men, I do believe, have been counted out of the ring. Our ring announcer Lucy Almeida conferring with the referee.
Ladies and gentlemen, the result of this match is a double count out.
That is the official decision, a double count out here. And we'll be right back with more on CCW Alive Wrestling. Tip back, wrestling fans. The bus has made his way back out here. Abbad trying to follow him out. The referees are stopping
That's
him.
That's not how this is supposed to finish tonight. Abbad, I want a rematch with you. June 25th, Port St. Lucie, you and me in the ring. We got to finish this. What do you got to say? Yeah. Are you too scared?
The bus challenging goodbye to a match on June 25th in his hometown of Port St. Lucie.
We're going to settle this once and for all.
Hi, wrestling fans. We'll be right back with more on CCW Alive. Wrestling fans, we're back on CCW Alive. It's Southeastern title time. Already in the ring, the challenger, Coach Jim Swanson. And there's the champion, Jackal Stevens from Runnymede, New Jersey.
Hey, 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 hey.
Jackal in tremendous condition right now. He's got a hold of Jim Swanson's hat for his visor. Trying to give Jim Swanson a dose of his own medicine. Not with Jackal Stevens. Enters the ring, holding that Southeastern title up in the air. Jackal Stevens not having any knee problems.
My knees are in great shape. I can do that stupid dance
with you. Swanson trying to do Jackal's dance to no avail. The Jackal jig. There's only one guy in CCW that can do that, and that's the Southeastern champion, Jackal Stevens. I'm not sure what Coach Swanson has in his right hand there. He came into the ring with it. I'm not sure why the referee is not getting it from him.
Best day in PE class. Ladies and gentlemen, it is parachute day.
Oh my God.
You've got a parachute before, haven't you?
Should I do this with this guy? Yes.
Is this PE class or is this wrestling? Swanson bringing out the parachute. I remember doing this when I was in grade school.
And then I'm going to kick your ass.
Not quite sure how this is going to work. Jackal's pretty smart. I know that Swanson's got to be up to something. I mean, he brought this thing out and he's got something in mind.
And I deserve respect.
They're playing parachute. What in the world? Referee.
Your mouth needs to be broken so you can sit down and be quiet.
Leading him back into the corner. The bell has not rung yet, as far as I know. Referee Andy Celia has not called for the bell.
You're not going to do it this time, are you?
I don't know how long these pre-match antics are going to go. Looks like it's more of a tug of war situation. Coach Jim Swanson is not having any success with the parachute he brought out. Now he seems to be trapped under it, finally getting it off. Stevens out of the way. It's got a wedgie. I guess the bell did sound earlier on. I didn't hear it. The referee officiating the match now, Jim Swanson and Jackal Stevens. Send him for the ride. Stevens coming to the elbow. He nailed it. Going to work a right hand on Jim Swanson. Swanson able to get him off. Beautiful drop kick right to the jaw. Stevens going to work now in the corner, right hands and boots to the midsection. It's Stevens really stopping a mud hole into the gym teacher, Jim Swanson. Swanson using some leverage and momentum, getting Jackal out of the ring to the floor, and he's right out after him. Ooh, Jackal out of the way of that chop. Swanson nailing that corner post with his hand, could have easily broken a couple of fingers. Stevens now coming back into the ring by way of the top rope. Leapfrogging over Swanson. Swanson, the nice power slam too. Oh, that was awful close. He almost caught the champion. Stevens now in trouble. Swanson in control. Stevens draped across that bottom rope. Swanson driving his neck into that bottom rope. Referee calling for the break. Stevens in trouble. Swanson again, a blatant choke right in front of the referee. His boot right in the throat. Ooh, and Stevens just tumbled to the outside, head first. Stevens in deep trouble on the outside of the ring. He's back to his feet now, though. Gets in with a knee and shoulder in the midsection. Up and over he goes. Stevens with a leg lariat, catches him. Goes for the cover, referee out of position. Two. Big clothesline by Swanson. Stevens goes down. Stevens in trouble. Swanson now with the cover. Game one. Just the one count. Stevens now trying to pull himself up by the ropes. Double axe handle smashing onto the back by Swanson. Referee up to a four count. Better be careful. Swanson risking disqualification. Stevens blocking the right hand, driving the head of Swanson into the turnbuckle. Now Stevens going to work on Swanson. Snap bears him out of the corner. Ooh, what a big kick to the back. Nice suplex. Referee there. Two. Stevens now with Swanson. Went for the super kick. Swanson caught it, though, spun him around into a clothesline. Stevens just bounced the back of his neck off the bottom rope, easily whiplashed himself there. Could have caused some serious damage. Now Swanson, running knee lift, caught him square in the temple. Goes for the cover, this could do it. We have a new champion, one, two, and no, just millimeters away. I had a great vantage point in that knee lift. It caught him right in the temple. I'm surprised Stevens is still able to have his wits about him and had the wherewithal to kick out of that. And again, Swanson now with a rear chin lock on the champ. Champ trying to get back up to his feet, and he's successful in doing so. Now driving Swanson back into the corner, breaking free. Swanson, though, out of the way of a charging Jackal Stevens. Has him perched up on that top rope, delivers a right hand to the jaw. Stevens and his championship in certain jeopardy here. Jim Swanson. No, sir, a big headbutt by Stevens. Swanson, unable to success. Oh, nailed it. That's going to do it. One, two, and three. He got it. Stevens retains the title. But I tell you what, it wasn't an easy night for the champion. Jim Swanson gave Malek a handle. That blockbuster nailed it, pitched perfectly done. And Steve is now with the Jackal chain. And he's victorious here on CCW Live Wrestling. We'll be right back, fans, with more after these words. Wrestling fans, we're back with CCW Live Wrestling. This next matchup is going to be a great one. The undefeated Meto taking on Malek Avalon. He calls himself an eagle amongst pigeons. Has a very high opinion of himself, and there you saw it. Justin extended his hand. As Meto went to shake it, he just pulled his hand away. Malek Avalon has a really high opinion of himself. Collar and elbows high up now in the center of the ring. They're going round and round now. Avalon. Now Avalon trying to power Meto back, but Meto able to grab a side headlock now and he has control. Nice on headlock takedown. Meto now controlling the match. Malek Avalon looking for a way out. Over one. Referee for this contest, Brandon Noel. Meto now with a side headlock. Avalon sent him to the ride, meets him in the center with a shoulder tackle. Down goes Avalon. Meto put on the brace, grab that headlock again. The Bulgarian Punisher in control now. Avalon looking for an escape now. He's grabbing him by the ear. Avalon back to his feet. Just winks him down by the waist. And then delivers a four to the side of the head and two right in a row. Meto really looks staggered now. Meto though holding on to the ropes. Oh, look out! Avalon landing on his feet on the apron, delivers a forearm. He went for that shoulder block in the midsection, but Meto was ready for him. Meto now driving the knee right into the chest. Dragging him back in. He's got a double underhook. Beautifully executed double underhook suplex. Nicely done by the Bulgarian Punisher. possibly going for that spear. Avalon had it scouted, sidestep, driving the shoulder right into the turnbuckle. And then a one-arm DDT. Meto in deep trouble now. That left arm has just taken two serious blows. And now Avalon going to work on the left arm, driving that knee right into the bicep. Now he's got a tip-top wrist lock with lots of leverage. Meto now up to a seated position. He really needs to get a vertical base, alleviate some of that pressure that he's got, that downward pressure that Avalon has on that shoulder. Now he's up, drives the right hand into the midsection. Avalon, though, just powering him back down. Meto in big trouble now. Shoulders on the mat for just a one count. Meto, of course, uses that spear as his finishing maneuver. He drives that left shoulder into the rib cage of his opponent, and that left shoulder is damaged. He may not be able to deliver that spear to its full effectiveness. And again, charging in, Avalon putting the elbow up, drop toe hold, bringing Meadow's head right down into the center turnbuckle. Avalon has this match well in hand. Oh, and he drives his shoulder again into the corner post that time. Avalon really did his homework. He was ready for the Bulgarian Punisher, and his strategy is paying off. Uh-oh, look out, Avalon coming out after him on the outside. Putting the boots to Meto now. Referee up to a four count. They're exchanging blows on the outside. Referee starting his count over. Now back in the ring, Avalon in after him. Avalon with a boot on the chest. You're not going to pin the Bulgarian Punisher like that. Again, Avalon going to work on that left shoulder of Meto. Crowd getting behind Meto now. But again, has that top wrist lock. Meto flat on his back. He's got all kinds of leverage now. Meto now trying to get back up to his feet. The crowd starting to come to life. Meto trying to draw off the crowd's energy. Drives the right hand in the midsection and again. And a third one will break the free, but oh, Avalon going to the eyes. Avalon now with a handful of tights. Again, sending Meto to the outside. And again, Avalon going after Meto. Double axe handle right to the back of the neck. Big heavy-handed chop right to the chest. Referee up to a six count. These two better be careful. Avalon back in the ring. That'll break the count. Avalon with a head of steam. Oh, Meto caught him coming out with a punch right to the head. Stopped Avalon right in his tracks. Avalon might be out cold. Meto needs to get back in the ring and finish him off. Meto now rolling back in under the bottom rope. Avalon trying to push his way back up into the ring. Here comes the Punisher. Big clothesline. Down goes Avalon and again. Meto now going to work. Reversal by Avalon. Blocking the hip toss. Throw arm overhead, belly to belly throw. He got him going for the cover now. This can do it. One, two. Tremendous matchup we're seeing here. Avalon not ready to call it quits. The Bulgarian Punisher now has new life. Avalon going for that reverse cradle. Meto holds onto the ropes, missing a clothesline though. Power slam. One, two. No, sir. Not enough. The crowd chanting for that spear. The question is, has too much damage been done to the shoulder of the Bulgarian Punisher for that spear to have its true effectiveness? Avalon now struggling back to his feet. Driving a knee into the midsection of a charging Meto. Side slam. Both men down. Avalon now back to his feet. I think Avalon says he's going to give Meto a spear. Crowd not happy with that. Bulgarian Punisher now. Meto now back to his feet. He cries over a charging Avalon. And again, I'm going to spear. That's going to do it. One, two, and three. He got it. Undefeated streak remains intact, and we'll be back with more on CCW Live right after this.
Your next match is scheduled for one fall. And it is for the CCW Cruiserweight Championship. Introducing first, from San Antonio, Texas, weighing out 199 pounds, the Wrangler, Nick.
we're back with CCW Live Wrestling. It's Cruiserweight Championship time. There's the champion making his way to the ring. This is a triple threat match. His opponents already in the square circle. They are the former CCW Cruiserweight Champion, Kriss and the Wrangler, Nick Turner. This should be a very interesting matchup. And of course, a triple threat match is a champion's worst nightmare. He does not even have to be involved with the outcome of the match, and he can still win that title. Alan S.U.S. Martinez making his way into the ring. As cocky and as arrogant as can be. A different Alan Martinez than we used to know. Ever since wrestling that title from around the waist of charismatic Kriss Farrow, he's just a different man altogether, and one that I don't particularly admire. Referee for this matchup, Christopher Costa, holding that title high in the air, signifying that that title is on the line.
Referee
calling for the bell. This one is underway. Expecting a lot of action in this one. Alan Martinez, though, takes right to the outside. Farrow and Turner now looking at one another. Martinez saying, go ahead and fight. But again, Martinez better be careful. If one of these men pins the other, say goodbye to your title. Power and elbow tie up now. The Wrangler and Turner go behind. Nice amateur waist lock takedown with a front face lock down. Kriss Farrow, nice escape into a hammerlock. The Wrangler now looking for a way out. Makes his way back to his feet. Nice reversal on that hammerlock. Slides right into a side headlock on Farrow. Farrow now trying to power his way out into a top wrist lock. But Turner out of the way. One, two. And then roll up. Martinez making sure there's no pinfall there. Turner making a mistake. Turning his back to Kriss Farrow. Farrow rolls him up. And again, Martinez making sure no pinfall occurs. And right back out goes S2S. Farrow and Turner looked at each other saying, go out the other way, let's get this son of a gun. And he blocks a right hand, and it's a ping pong time. Turner and now Farrow throwing S2S back in the ring. Now we got a double team situation. They send it to Rise. Rise, double hip toss. Turner going for the cover. Turner with Martinez in the corner. Across he goes. Farrow now with the assist by Turner, slamming right into S2S. S2S out of the way of a charging Nick Turner. Missing a clothesline. Rise spinning like Lariat. Caught Farrow right in the forehead. S2S with a leaping forearm. And now one for Farrow. And across, he nailed Turner. Farrow. Remember Martinez out of the way. He nailed Turner in the corner. Martinez down. Nice vertical suplex. Taking the legs out from under the Wrangler. Basement dropkick on both of his opponents. Goes for the cover. One, two. Look out, Costa had his foot on the rope. Be careful, Christopher Costa. He's doing it again. Costa, look out. Farrow trying to make his way back to his feet. Allen S2S Martinez measuring now. Farrow blocking the right hand. Martinez firing away. Shots on both of his opponents. Big injury. He just nailed Turner. Turner could be out. One, two. almost a short powerbomb type maneuver. Very innovative by Alan Martinez. Alan Martinez calling for the go to sleep. Farrow struggling to get back to his feet. He's got him up for it. Farrow, though, had it scouted, broke free from the O'Connor roll. Martinez hanging on, missing the clothesline. Springboard moves on, nailed him. Could have him here. One, two. Turner able to bring up the pin just in the nick of time. Martinez now. Farrow could be setting up for sliced bread. Just shoved right into the Wrangler. Wrangler down on the apron of the ring. Farrow delivering a clothesline. Martinez in the corner to nice edge chop. And another knife edge chop to Martinez. Reversal by Martinez into the corner. Goes Chris Farrow. Martinez in with a clothesline now. Send him across. A nice reversal by Farrow that time. Now Farrow connects with the clothesline. The Wrangler, Nick Turner on the outside, struggling to get back into the ring. Over the monkey flip. No. Martinez put on the brakes and turned around. Set Farrow up on the top rope. Could be going for the superplex here. Or a super canrana. Looks like it's coming up. Turner. Martinez in the electric chair. Oh my goodness gracious. It's a car wreck in the center of the ring. All three men down. There could be some serious injuries to the neck of Nick Turner or the back of Chris Farrow or the neck of Alan Martinez. That did not look pretty. They hit with an abrupt halt. All three men now struggling to get back up to their feet. The Wrangler blocking the right hand, delivering one of his own. And again, Martinez trying for the right. The Wrangler underneath the clothesline. Big clothesline by the Wrangler to Turner. And a back elbow now. He's got the champion reeling. Full Nelson standing. He nailed him. He could have him here. He could do it. One, two. Oh no, Chris Farrow. Able to break up the pin just in the nick of time. Martinez now rolling towards the outside. Farrow with Turner firing away with a knife edge chop again. Turner with a full Nelson. He was going for the full Nelson slam on Farrow, but Farrow able to block it. He got sliced bread on Turner, but one, two, three, he got him. Farrow nailed Turner with sliced bread. Martinez took advantage and got the cover. A tremendous Cruiserweight matchup here on CCW Live. We'll be right back, wrestling fans, after these words. Wrestling fans, we're back on CCW Live in the ring now. The self-proclaimed one and only South American superstar, Mr. Ariel Levy. Fans here in the CCW arena giving him what for. Levy attacking his partner Vinicius. Putting him on the shelf now with severe concussion issues. Newcomer here to Coastal Championship Wrestling. I've had the opportunity to see him wrestle a couple of times. Big test for the young man here. He's well aware of the skills of one Ariel Levy. Both of them trained and got their start in the country of Chile. Chris Hector over the top rope, ready for action. Gotta be careful not to turn his back on Ariel Levy. And again, I knew it. Once was bad enough, turning his back on the second time was a rookie mistake. Levy now driving an elbow into the base of the skull. The crowd chanting against Levy. His partner, or former partner, Vinicius, the Brazilian destroyer, out of action for the time being with a major concussion given to him at the hands of one Ariel Levy. Levy now on the attack again against Chris Vector. Vector hard into the buckle he goes. Double knees right to the chest. Levy incredibly proud of himself. Oh, nailed him with both knees right in the face. Chris Vector in trouble now. Levy, oh, Vector, and it's scouted. Levy was going for that T-bone suplex. Big scoop, nice body slam by Chris Vector. Vector with a head of steam, popping a leg across the chest. Goes to the cover, one, two. Wow, almost a major upset here on CCW Alive. And Ariel Levy now rolling to the outside. Vector, though, right after him. I think he baited him right in, snapping that neck on the top rope. Again, driving the elbow to the base of the skull. And snapping that neck and back against that middle rope. Levy really giving our fans a hard time at ringside here. Levy wanting to know why he even has to bother dealing with the likes of Kriss Vector. I think you would prefer if someone just hands him a championship belt and he doesn't have to do anything to earn it. That's the kind of attitude that's oozing off the South American superstar Ariel Levy. Levy now with Vector. Vector trying to put on the brakes, but Levy moving to the midsection. Nice reversal by Vector. Drop toe hold. That'll do some damage to the pretty face of Ariel Levy. He's got the leg grapevine. We have a submission maneuver here. We could see a serious upset. Oh. Levy going to the eyes. Move to the midsection again. Levy now with Vector. Vector putting on the brakes one more time. Driving great hands into the midsection. Nice forearm to the side of the head. Has the South American superstar on rubbery legs. Vector now. Oh, he kicked him right. Looked like he got him right in the knee. Oh, what a running knee. Caught him right in the face. All he's got to do is go for the cover, and that's going to do it. Here it is. One, two. No. Vector able to escape. Levy now with right hands, possibly out of sheer frustration. He's not been able to defeat Vector. Not quite the easy opponent that Levy had expected. Vector showing us a lot here in his match against the South American superstar Ariel Levy. Levy now to the outside. Says he's going to the top. Levy on that top rope. Vector up quickly, caught him with a forearm. Levy now in trouble. Vector going for it all. Vector now has him hooked. Nicely executed superplex. Vector favoring his lower back though, and Levy wisely rolling away from the center of the ring. Vector unable to capitalize. Both men down. Referee administers the count now. Levy back up to his feet. That'll break the count. Vector now back up to his. Big clothesline by Vector. And a back elbow puts Ariel Levy flat on his back. Levy now in the corner. Vector went for it all. Nicely done. German suplex two. All so close. Kriss Vector, bring it all. Looking for the upset victory to catapult him up in the rankings here in CCW. The crowd wants it a three count. Arguing with the referee is Kriss Vector, but he's wasting his time. He needs to go after Ariel Levy while he's got him down. Vector now. Charging. He went for that knee. Levy able to grab it. Roll him over. He's got a single leg Boston Crab now. Rearing back. Levy with the crab. Vector. Is he going to give up or can he reach the ropes or possibly escape? Now he's got a full Boston Crab. And he's got it deep in there. Vector in serious trouble now. Vector rolling himself over. And Levy driving a boot to the midsection. Levy rolling through. Two. Vector, rolling through. Nice pinning combination. Kriss Vector showing me a lot. Missing a clothesline, though. Oh, and a code breaker. He nailed him. That could do it. Referee there. One, two, and three. Well, Levy victorious, but certainly not the cakewalk that he was expecting. Kriss Vector, king of life, showed us a lot in this outing here. Expect great things from Kriss Vector and CCW. But for tonight, Ariel Levy gets the good. Wrestling fans, we'll be back with more on CCW and live wrestling right after this. ladies action. Enter the ring now, Jessie Elaban, making her CCW debut. Elaban from Austin, Texas, standing 5 feet, 9 inches tall. She's going to have a tremendous weight advantage against her opponent, Anna Diaz. Elaban played volleyball for California University, Texas, in 2010.
Anna Diaz.
She's going to have her hands for a debut against Anna Diaz. Diaz, tremendous competitor here, has had great success in CCW. Official for this match, senior official Bruce Owens. Jessie Elaban calls herself the most sophisticated wrestler here in Coastal Championship Wrestling. Ah, come on. Elaban and Elaban putting on her hat. Elaban with about a five inch height advantage over Anna Diaz. Anna gets a double top. Power elbow tie now in the center of the ring. Elaban trained by Sarah Del Rey at the WWE Performance Center. She spent a good period of time in NXT. A couple of shots on the main roster. WWE's loss is CCW's gain. Anna Diaz trained under the tutelage and continues to train under the tutelage of former WWE superstar Gangrel. So certainly both ladies have had the training that they need to be victorious in any encounter. Elaban now taking her time with Anna Diaz. Colorado will tie up again. Diaz looking for an advantage, driving a knee into the midsection. Over the backslide, right out of the gate. Referee, 1, 2. Elaban now with a knee to the midsection. And an elbow hook, 1, 2. Referee Bruce Owens better have his working boots on tonight. A pair of knees to the midsection again. Anna Diaz now. Small package, could have her, 1, 2. Kick to the back. Elaban, Nicely done, tripping Diaz up. He's gonna roast with some momentum and drives that elbow right into the chin. Elaban now, vicious under attack and in control, driving a boot into the midsection of Adam Diaz. Elaban now showing a mean streak. Ooh! And a kick right to the chest. Driving Adam's head right into the top turnbuckle now. Going to work with boots in the midsection to gather the corner there. Elaban now with some momentum, some leverage on that bottom rope. Diaz swept in the corner. Elaban very proud of herself. Oh, a little cartwheel, why not? Nothing to be effective against Anna Diaz, though she better stay on the attack. Now she is after her. Referee calling for the break as they are in the ropes. Elaban to the outside. Diaz in a very precarious position. Oh! A kick right to the side of the head. Elaban now standing on the chest of Anna Diaz. Diaz now driving it over in the midsection, having some effect, and a third one, but a boot to the midsection by Jessie Elaban. Center for a ride, Anna under the clothesline. She went for the backdrop, Anna hold on, one, two, nice sunset flip almost had her, but a beautiful drop kick finds its mark. Elaban now going to work with right hands. Diaz covering up, protecting that head. Diaz firing back with kicks. One to the elbow, then one to the leg. But Elaban with a boot to the chest. Ooh, nicely done. Elaban driving that knee into the bicep, holding the arm across the leg. Elaban in control now, Diaz in trouble. Diaz firing a right hand forearm into the hip area of Elaban. Elaban though, dropping that leg across the arm. He's got a scissor, she goes for the cover. Diaz able to power out, that left arm has burnt some damage. Anna clutching at her arm. Elaban. She better stay on that arm if she has any hopes of beating Diaz. Diaz is a double plus right to the chest. Elaban now firing back. They're exchanging blows now. Anna Diaz with a couple of chops. Oh, Elaban caught her good right in the chest. Hand full of hair, driving at his face right into the mat. Goes for the cover, referee out of position. Two. Diaz able to power out. Crowd and encouraging Anna to get up. Elaban had a handful of hair there and it moved right to the rib cage. And again, Elaban with the hair of Diaz just dragging her across the ring. Come on, referee! Slamming her head into the mat. Elaban showing a real mean streak. The crowd not happy with her here. She doesn't see the hair, but the crowd thinks here it goes to championship wrestling. Elaban using that bottom rope with some momentum and leverage, dropping an elbow across the chest, and now just pie-facing Diaz and scraping her back of her head against the mat, just with disdain. Now you don't want to get Anna Diaz angry. She's got a short move as it is. Now grabbing at her leg, Diaz coming back up, rolling her up, referee right there, one, two. Elaban driving her down with a clothesline. Diaz in deep trouble. Elaban, referee, I'm telling you, Bruce, wake up. Her shoulders were down. Referee hesitated. Diaz now making her way back to the corner now. Some separation between her and her opponent. Elaban charges only to meet the elbow of Diaz right in the face. Come on. Cruiserweight back to a vertical base. The crowd coming up, coming behind, and Diaz, and Diaz now. Jawbreaker, nicely done by Anna Diaz, able to create some separation. Out of the way of a charging Elaban. Blocks the kick, Matrix. Oh, but a duck. Nailed her with a clothesline, finally. Elaban down. Got her with a kick that time to the back. Diaz now, with a look of determination on her face. Round on back, finish for the elbow. She got her good. Great momentum. Has Elaban on the rope, so to speak. T-bone suplex, nicely done. Goes for the cover. One, two. Only a two count. Elaban able to power out. Diaz now. As the crowd comes to life. A handful of hair. She's got the front face lock on. What's she going for? Elaban able to spin out of it. Nicely done. Driving a boot right into the chest of Anna Diaz. Leaping forearm. Nailed Diaz in the corner. Nice sit out power bomb. Could do it here. Two. Diaz kicked out, and in doing so, caught Elaban right in the head. Both ladies now making their way back to their feet. Wow. Elaban, she caught Diaz with a kick right in the ribcage. Big swoop. No, Diaz turtles free. She got the sleeper hook. She's got it hooked. She's got that sleeper hold hook that could do it. She leaps on the back. Elaban trying to break free. Diaz has a tight grip. Elaban in serious jeopardy. She's down. Elaban rolls over, their shoulders are down. Two, Randy's got her feet on the ropes. Elaban gets the victory. Her feet were on the ropes though. Referee not seeing it. Elaban stole one from Anna Diaz. Tremendous matchup. Diaz had her in that choke, that rear naked choke sleeper hold. I thought it was all over, but Elaban able to hold back with that long body of her. And center rope, more leverage, kept Diaz's shoulders to the mat while the referee had it, not with the gun. Big win by Jessie Elaban. But Anna Diaz robbed, in my as I know this is a non-title matchup.
Hold on, hold on, hold on. Hey, that's a weapon to put down. You gotta settle down. What I'd like to have right now is for all you Pompano Beach pinheads, keep the noise down, especially you guys, and show Francisco Ciatso the respect that he deserves.
His request for respect.
You know, I want me to be standing here tonight. CCW, the Supreme Clutch Team, Francisco Ciatso, signed the contract 2 days ago. Twitter was tweeting, Instagram didn't know what to do with their hands. But what I didn't know, complete oversight on my part, is that you are the BRCW Heavyweight Champion. Everybody here knows that you are a champion of the people. If you're the man that you claim you are, if you are the champion that you claim to be, we'll do a little gentleman's agreement tonight. Me and you, in front of CCW, God, and the whole world, you put that BRCW Heavyweight Championship on the line right now.
Francisco Ciatso wants this to be a title match. As I had expected, it was a non-title match. I certainly don't think that Lakay will back down from a challenge from anybody. He's given a thumbs up. I guess that means this is a title match. Maybe the referee, maybe the ring announcer can confer with the referee to verify and announce that this actually is a title match.
Ladies and gentlemen, I've just been informed that this is now a title match for the BRCW Championship.
So, fans, we do have a title match. Ciatso. Going for the attack from behind. Lakay was ready for him. Lakay now firing back. That's Ciatso on the ropes, both literally and figuratively. In the corner now. Ciatso to the outside. Ciatso calling for timeout. That's not going to stop the referee's count, though. After eight count, finally Ciatso getting back into the ring. Ciatso extending a hand. The guy, I'm sure he knows better, don't trust this man. Not as far as you can throw him. Lakay shaking the hand. Oh, he's crushing the hand. Lakay incredibly powerful. Stomping on the hand of Francisco Ciatso. And Lakay delivering a knife edge chop to the chest. Ciatso in trouble now. Lakay bouncing it from pillar to post. Heading to the turnbuckle he goes. Kick right to the nether regions of Lakay. Snapmares him over. And he tries an elbow right to the top of the head of Lakay. Ciatso with all 242 pounds. Riding in the back, neck, and shoulders of Lakay. Trying to wear him down. Crowd coming away. Lakay. Just as he was getting back up, Ciatso breaks. Ciatso driving that knee right into the forehead, one time, and then back to the chin lock. Once again, Francisco Ciatso, a real true veteran of the ring, 20 plus years. He's not affected by the fans here, even though he may show it. He's a very slow and methodical pace. He designs his matches to wear down his opponent. He doesn't care how long it takes. He's in no hurry to do anything except deliver punishment. Lakay, though, an incredible show of strength. Again, putting on the brakes with a knee to the midsection and a shot to the head. Big body slam, Lakay down in the center of the ring. Ciatso with his hand raised. Fans are not impressed. Ciatso now over the middle rope. Lakay out of the way, thankfully. That's 240 pounds of Francisco Ciatso being cracked down. Lakay trying to make his way back to his feet. Ciatso doing the same. Lakay blocked to the right. And again, Lakay now firing away with right hands. Sends him for the ride, harder than Buckles. Ciatso, Lakay following him with a splash. Heads him across the ring. Downward spirally goes. Two and three. He got it. We hope to enjoy the main event here on CCW Live Wrestling from the CCW Arena. And we'll see.